Ah, Eddie Jones. Love him or loathe him, England's head coach has certainly ruffled some feathers over the years with his selections and failures to call up in-form players. Now, there's no knocking Eddie's credentials here, and certainly when it comes to selection, his job is to select the best team to get the result. But he does have a habit of ignoring the in-form fan favourites. So here are 8 England players who have been exiled from Eddie Island. 2019 European Player of the Year, Alex Good was a key cog in the Saracens machine over the years, and he earned 21 caps for England, the last of them coming under Jones when England played Fiji at Twickenham in 2016. During the Jones era, he sat on the bench 3 times, coming off it once. When he did start against Fiji, he scored a try. Since his last game though for England, he fell out of favour, and no matter what he achieved at the club level, the door was closed, which left many fans and pundits scratching their heads. Having led Exeter to the double last season, it seemed like the Autumn Nations Cup would be a prime opportunity for Eddie to experiment and bring in some new players, with Joe probably most deserving of a shot on the international stage. The call never came though, as Eddie stayed loyal to Owen Farrell and George Ford. Simmons' Exeter teammate Don Armand's opportunities with England only seemed to come when Eddie Jones and his side endured a number of injuries. Twice capped, Don has been an absolute giant for the Chiefs over the years, and his versatility to play across all 3 back row positions. No matter how well he played, his face just didn't fit the international scene, much to the dismay of fans. The story of Danny and Eddie is a roller coaster. Over the years, there is no doubting Danny Cipriani's unbelievable talent, with Eddie also recognising it. It's clear though that Eddie just wasn't a fan of all the press and media attention that Danny got. Saying in his 2020 autobiography, the reaction from the press was outrageous. They thought Cipriani had proved he was a rugby genius. It was one good moment, but he had been very quiet throughout the rest of the game. Despite being crowned the double premiership player of the season for his scintillating performances in his first season at Gloucester, Eddie still wasn't won over. And Eddie stated in his autobiography, "I just thought Farrell and Ford were both better players at test level than Cipriani." The comments by Jones appear to hit a nerve, with Cipriani responding, "He said more about me in a book than he has ever said to me. He's never said 2 words to me." Oof, frosty. After being named as an apprentice in the England party for the 2018 Six Nations, Marcus has yet to be capped. There's no doubting he needed to get more game time in and learn his craft in the Premiership, but many pundits and fans believe now is the time for Smith to be called up after impressing for Quins over the recent season. But as people praise Marcus for his mature game management, there is a genuine fear that we could be going round and round with Eddie's stubbornness to change and blooding new talent. Marcus's Quins halfback partner Danny Kerr has been playing some of his best rugby of late, and with fans' frustration for Eddie's loyalty to Ben Youngs, then you have to feel for Danny Kerr. Former England 9 Kieran Bracken revealed Danny Kerr made the big mistake of speaking his mind to Eddie Jones, questioned how he wanted to play when he was playing for England against Japan in the autumn of 2018. Eddie's response to that was, "That's not the attitude I want," and he binned him from his plans. Bristol and former Wasp number 8, Nathan Hughes has certainly been on his own journey with England, having received 22 caps and being a solid option for Eddie Jones as a backup for Billy Vunipola over the years. With Jones favouring flankers instead of an out-and-out 8 when Billy has been injured, Nathan can certainly feel hard done by, as he's been excellent for Bristol in recent seasons. And finally, in-form and dynamic number 8, Sam Simmons has all the reasons to feel frustrated at the moment. Arguably the player of the year so far in the Premiership with a superb try scoring record, he has all the qualities to be an outstanding international. Having received 7 caps, it seems like Simmons isn't even in the mind of Eddie currently. Speaking to Rugby Journal recently, Sam says Eddie told him how he plays for Exeter, it just doesn't fit into his squad. Will we get to see Sam in an England shirt before the end of the year? Or could we even see him on the Lions tour? Let us know in the comments who you would like to see in an England shirt come the end of the year. If you're new to Fab Rugby, make sure you hit like and subscribe in this video. And guys, I'll see you soon for the next video.